Hello everyone, Miss Waring here. I miss you guys, so I just wanted to make a video to encourage you and hopefully bring you some joy through all this. So we know that these are very interesting and kind of challenging times that we're in, and it's normal to feel anxious and scared and a little restless. But we might as well use this time that God has given us to rest and to recharge. Although, if you're like me, you're probably going a little crazy looking for some activities to keep your mental sanity. So I have come up with some ideas for you to do and to try in your home. This will help improve your mental, but also your physical wellness while you're home and increase your relationship with your friends and your family, as well as practicing some self-care. So first of all, you can make a list of things that you are grateful for and take some time to thank God for what He has blessed you with. You can video chat your friends and family that you haven't seen because of social distancing. You could go on a walk or find a way to stay active. Physical activity greatly improves your mood and your brain functioning. You could read the Bible or a really good book. You could have a dance party with yourself or with your family members. Show kindness to your parents by helping out around the house. Do things like folding laundry or do the dishes. These are things I know you love to do. Sing some karaoke to your favorite tunes.
If I was your girlfriend, I'd never let you go. I can take you places you ain't ever been before. Baby, take a chance so you'll never ever know. I got money in my hands that I really like to blow.
Or spend some quality time with your family. Try playing a game or putting together a puzzle. Do some yoga or practice mindfulness to help relieve anxious thoughts. So these are all fun activities that can entertain us and are great for our mental health. However, I have found that personally in my life, it's important for me to pray and to remember the promises that God has given us in His Word. In one of my recent Bible studies, I have been studying the story of Noah and the Ark. I'm sure you guys know that story, it's very popular. But did you know that Noah was on the ark with his family for almost a year? Almost 1 year. I mean, that's a lot of animal poop and that's a lot of boring nights on a boat. But if Noah can patiently stay on that boat and trust God and His faithfulness for a year, don't you think that we can do it for a few weeks? But the really cool thing is that whole time that Noah was on that boat, God never forgot about Noah. And God was with Noah. And the same is true for us. God is with us through this pandemic. None of this is a surprise to God. And He promises us that He will help us face whatever is coming our way. All we need to do is trust Him. Psalm 46, I was reading the other day, it says, God is our refuge and strength, a helper who is always found in times of trouble. Therefore, we will not be afraid. The same psalm also says, be still and know that I am God. So God's basically commanding us not to fear because He's got everything under control. He's got it in the bag. This specific psalm also refers to God as Lord of Hosts, and it says the Lord of Hosts is with us. Basically meaning that God has an army of angels and heavenly hosts on His side. I don't know about you, but I'm pretty sure that's the team that I want to be on, because you can bet your bottom dollar that they're going to win every single time. It goes back to one of my favorite sayings. We don't know what the future holds, but we know who holds the future. And that is an awesome God with a kick butt army. So that's basically what I have for you today. Thank you for tuning in. If you need anything, feel free to contact me. You have my email, or you can fill out the form that is linked below. All right, have a great day, guys. It's gonna be what it is gonna be. Stop it. Go away. Stop. Okay. That's about enough. You're still there. I can see you. Hello, everyone. Miss Waring here. Bro, come on. You're killing me, Smalls.